Dear students, in our previous class, we studied about hemispheres, land hemisphere, water hemisphere, northern hemisphere and also southern hemisphere. Apart from this, we also studied about longitude and latitudes. Students, now what is the clear meaning of the terms latitude and longitude? Latitude and longitudes. Yes, this is 8th social part, 2nd, 3rd part. Yes. The name of the lesson is, you know, the Earth, our living planet. Yes, what is latitudes and what is longitudes? We already studied about latitudes and longitudes are imaginary lines imagined by geographers. Therefore, It is not God made, it is man made. Through his imagination. Why? Because to know the position, direction and places or conditions of a particular place. What is position means? For example, Delhi. In which longitude it comes? To know such matters, these latitudes and longitudes plays an important role. Now the question is, what is latitudes? The first point is, it is an imaginary line. Imaginary lines. It applies both latitudes and also longitudes, imaginary lines. Then these latitudes are horizontal lines. Horizontal lines. Horizontal to what? Horizontal to which? Horizontal to 0 degree equator. This is equator, you know, isn't it? Yes, the degree 0 degree. It is called equator. It is a pair horizontal to equator. What is horizontal means? Level. Actually, in this way, little bit across. These latitudes are horizontal lines both in the northern hemisphere and southern hemisphere. This is a horizontal, equal, level lines to this equator. Therefore, latitudes are an imaginary lines. They are also horizontal to the equator. the length of lines of latitudes decreases with the distance from the equator. See here, imagine, what is this? This is a globe or our earth. See, the length of these latitudes are decreases, not increases. This is NP. What is NP means? 90 degree north pole. In the same way here also. This is SP. Who is SP? Here SP means southern pole. Here the length of the line is big. Equator. This is the length is big. In the southern poles, it will decreases up to south pole. In the same way, the northern hemisphere also, from the equator to the north, the length of the lines are decreases. Length of the lines are decreases. All lines of latitudes are circles and parallel to the equator. One another point is parallel to the what? Equator. Parallel to the equator. What is parallel means? Parallel means equal. Or what you say in Kannada? Samanantara. Yes, level. Circles and parallel to the equator, therefore lines of latitude are called parallels of latitude. Lines of these lines, lines of latitudes are also called what? Parallels of latitudes. Parallel of latitudes. Why? Because all these latitudes, both in the northern hemisphere and southern hemisphere, they are parallel to this equator. Parallel to this equator, therefore, latitudes are also known as parallels of latitude. Yes, I think you understood the point. Now, there are 90 degree of latitudes on each side of the equator. Each side of the equator. How many degrees of latitudes? 90 degree of latitudes. Then 90 degree of north and south are points. 90 degree north pole. 90 degree south pole. Including equator totally, there are 181 latitudes. Therefore, there are 90 into 2, that is 180 latitudes. Plus this equator, how much? 181 latitudes are there totally. There are 181 latitudes. Students, look here, this is globe. See, these lines are called latitudes. See here, latitudes. Both in the northern hemisphere and the southern hemisphere. Thus, it is horizontal lines to the equator. The length of these latitudes are smaller and smaller and smaller up to the north pole. Here also it is the length decreases up to the south pole. Therefore, these circles semicircles, the length is decreases. Therefore, this is these lines are what? Latitudes. Therefore, students, latitudes are an imaginary lines and horizontal lines. It is drawn in a globe from east to west. Drawn from east to west. That is called latitudes. This is equator. These are all horizontal lines to this equator. Therefore, the latitudes are known as parallels of latitudes. Parallel of latitudes. Now, there are 181 latitudes including the 0 degree equator. In Kannada, Bhumadhya Rekhe. This is equator, the green line that indicates what? Equator or Bhumadhya Rekhe. Is next. Now, there are some important latitudes. 7 important latitudes are there. First one is 0 degree latitude. 0 degree latitude. 0 degree latitude. Yes. First one, 0 degree or 0 degree latitude. 0 degree latitude. This is important latitudes. There are 7 important latitudes. Next one, north latitude. 23.5 degree. North latitude. North latitude. It is also called what? Tropic of Cancer. Tropic of Cancer. Next, third one, 23.5 degree south latitude. South latitude. That is also called Tropic of Capricorn. Capricorn. In Kannada, Karkataka Sankranti Vritta and Makara Sankranti Vritta. Yes, fourth one. Fourth one, 66.5 degree north latitude. NL. North latitude. Fifth one, 66.5 degree of south latitude. South latitude. The north latitude is Arctic. Arctic. Arctic Circle. Arctic Circle. This is Antarctic. Antarctic Circle. Antarctic Circle. Next one is 90 degree. You know, see here, 90 degree north pole and 90 degree south pole. Sixth one, north pole, NP, that is 90 degree, and seventh one, south pole, that is also 90 degree. Therefore, students, now we have understood the meaning of latitude, and the next concept is, that is, which are the important latitudes we discussed now. How many important latitudes are there? 7. 0 degree latitude, 0 degree latitude, that is none other than equator. Okay, then 23.5 north latitude, 23.5, this one equator, 23 north latitude, it is also called Tropic of Cancer. Next one, 23.5 degree south latitude, that is also called Tropic of Capricorn. Then 66.5 degree north Arctic, this line here, Arctic, in the same way, in the southern hemisphere, this is Antarctic. Then North Pole and South Pole, these are the important latitudes. Then, so after discussing about latitudes, the next step is longitudes. This is in Kannada, Akshamsha. This is Rekamsha. This is just like Reke. Reke. This is A. Akshamsha. A. Don't make in this way. Okay, for your memory. Yes, longitudes. I already told that longitudes are also imaginary lines. Imaginary lines that intersects equator at a right angle joining the north and south are called longitudes. This is only for our what? Information. Imagine this is globe, equator, northern hemisphere, southern hemisphere. Northern hemisphere also called land hemisphere, southern hemisphere also called water hemisphere. Now this is the center point, equator, 0 degree. See these lines, these lines are called what? Longitudes. It is also imaginary levels, sorry, imaginary lines. What's the importance? Known to know a direction, position and a condition of a particular place. These longitudes plays an important role. Yes sir, this lines that intersect equator, it passes through the equator, samabhajaka vruttada moolaka, through the equator at a right angle joining the North Pole and South Pole. All these longitudes join here at North Pole and also South Pole. These are called longitudes. On the globe, longitudes are shown as a series of semicircles that run from pole to pole passing through the equator. Yes, these longitudes are semicircles, half circles. Semi means half. All these semicircles join or intersects at the North Pole and South Pole. These are called longitudes. Therefore, what is the clear-cut definition? Clear-cut meaning for these longitudes? longitudes are imaginary lines. It passes through the equator and it are parallel to the parallel lines to the equator and it joins at the north pole and the north pole and the south pole. Yes, these longitudes are not horizontal latitudes. These are vertical lines. What is vertical means? Here vertical means perpendicular. Yes, these are called longitudes. Equator, semicircles, imaginary lines. It intersects or intersect at a particular point, both in north pole and south pole. All lines of longitudes are of equal length. See here, these lines, these are called what? Longitudes. These are latitudes. These lines are longitudes. These longitudes are equal length. For in our previous class, I told that the length of the latitudes are decreasing both at the southern hemisphere and northern hemisphere. But here, regarding longitudes, these are the same lines. It can't increase, can't decrease. These are called longitudes. These longitudes are also called meridians. These longitudes are also called meridians. Why? Do you know? Can you imagine? Longitudes are called meridians. Why? Because it has two terms, meri and dians. What is meri means? Here, meri means mid. Meri means mid. Andre, sorry, means mid means middle. Dian means noon. Dian means noon or 12 o'clock. Therefore, meri means mid, dian means noon, but we take it as day. Take it as day. Therefore, meridian means midday. This is very important term, midday. The meridian passing through Greenwich. Where is Greenwich? In England. The meridian means longitude. It passes through Greenwich in England has been chosen as prime meridian. Here equator is prime. In longitude, this meridian is prime. Prime is important. It passes through Greenwich in England. It is marked as 0 degree longitude. For example, see the map. Yes, what is this blue color that indicates what? Meridian, longitude, degree, 0 degree. It is called prime meridian. Why this longitude is called prime meridian? Yes, we shall find out answer few minutes later. Okay. Yes, there are 180 of longitudes. See, the total 181 latitudes. Here there are 180 of the longitudes at the east of the Greenwich. 180. The same, another 180 in the west side of this longitude. This is east, therefore it is called eastern hemisphere. This is west side, west direction, therefore it is called western hemisphere. Yes, thus totally 180 plus 180 means how much? 360 of longitudes. Total there are 360 of longitudes to the east of Greenwich. East 180, west 180. Total 360. The zone between the prime meridian and 180 east longitude is called eastern hemisphere. This part from 0 degree to the east, it is called eastern hemisphere. 0 degree to the west, it is called western hemisphere. That is the name of directions: east hemisphere, west hemisphere, north pole, south pole. Means northern hemisphere and southern hemisphere. The opposite zone is called western hemisphere. West side of this line is called western hemisphere. East side is called eastern hemisphere. The distance between two consecutive longitudes decreases gradually with the distance from the equator. The length or the distance, see here, this is Greenwich and next longitude is this. The length of this longitude are also decreases gradually with the distance of the equator. This is equator. See here, the length is more here. If you come western side from the equator, the length is also decreases. Length is decreases like latitudes. This is because of the meridians of longitude converge. Converge means tend to one point. See here, globe. All the longitudes are join here. Therefore, on the equator, the distance between two consecutive meridians is 111 kilometers. Distance from the longitudes from the equator is 111 kilometers. In map, it is near to the equator. Actually, the distance is 111 kilometers. Yes, students, now in this period, we studied completely about latitudes and longitudes, its importance, and which are the important latitudes, what is eastern hemisphere, what is eastern and what is western hemisphere, etc. Now, in our next class, we shall study about longitude and time. Longitude and time. Sai Ram.